ओके, यू आर एबल टू सी दिस बुक ऑन योर स्क्रीन वृंदा? हेलो, राइट, व्हाट इज द हेडिंग ऑफ द कंटेंट? बोन ट्यूमर्स, राइट. एंड ईशा, यू आर ऑल्सो एबल टू सी द बुक ऑन योर स्क्रीन? ओके, सो गुड इवनिंग एवरीबडी. टूडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट बोन ट्यूमर्स, ओके, विच इज अ टॉपिक फ्रॉम योर सब्जेक्ट ऑर्थोपेडिक्स. इट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक बिकॉज इट इज मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क इन द एग्जामिनेशन. दे कैन आस्क एमसीक्यूज फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर एज वेल एज दे कैन आस्क 15 मार्क लॉन्ग आंसर्स, एंड ऑल्सो सम ऑफ द ट्यूमर्स कैन कम एज शॉर्ट आंसर्स फॉर 3 मार्क्स. सो प्लीज पे अटेंशन. सो वॉट इज अ बोन ट्यूमर? So the term bone tumor is a broad term used for benign and malignant neoplasms as well as tumor like condition of the bone. So neoplasm, or you say bone tumors, it is the same thing. So metastatic deposits will be there in the bone, and these are common than primary bone tumors. So what is happening in case of malignancy? There is abnormal cell growth inside the bone. So in case of malignancies, multiple myeloma is also common. Osteochondroma is the commonest benign tumor of the bone. Okay, so one second, I'll admit Maitri. So you are able to see the screen now on your screen? This book is visible on your screen? Okay, so osteochondroma is also common type of benign bone tumor. Most primary malignant bone tumors occur in children and in young adults. So in whom these constitute one of the common malignant tumors. The nature of a bone tumor can be suspected based on the type of the destruction seen on the x-ray. So when we see the x-ray of the patient who are having bone tumors, so there will be changes. Their bones won't look normal on the x-ray. So depending on how much destruction they have caused to the bone that is visible on the x-ray, depending on that we can classify the tumors. Okay, so types of the lesions radiographically, they are saying different type of lesion will be there depending on its aggression, and their example is given in this table. So type of lesion, geographic lesion. Suppose it is well-defined lesion and it is least aggressive, then example of that is simple bone cyst. Okay, so least aggressive means it will not spread to the other area. Okay, more aggressive means it can spread to the other area and the transmission of the tumor will be faster. It can affect other systems also. Moth eaten and less well-defined with a moth eaten appearance. So, and more aggressive type of a tumor, example of this kind of tumor can be low grade osteosarcoma and giant cell tumor. See, giant cell tumor is also called as GCT. So later in the chapter we will discuss more in detail about the giant cell tumor. Permeative lesion, which is least defined and most aggressive type. So example for this type of tumor is your telangiectatic osteosarcoma. Okay, so what is a benign tumor? Okay, so when we talk about the tumor, we can generally classify the tumors into two types, that is the benign tumor as well as the malignant tumor. Benign means it can be, the tumor will be present but it will be only localized to one particular area and it will not spread to other parts of the body. When you say malignant bone tumors, that means it will originate, it will generate in one part of the bone and then it will transmit to other parts of the bone, as well as it can affect the bone as well as other systems of the body also. So those kind of tumors are called as the malignant tumors, and benign tumors are the ones, you can say benign tumors are the mild ones, in while opposite to that the malignant tumors are more severe form of tumors. So one of the example of the benign bone tumor is your osteoma. So this is osteoma is a benign tumor composed of a sclerotic well-formed bone protruding from the cortical surface of the bone. So this osteoma will come out of the cortical surface of the bone. So the bones involved most often are the skull and the facial bones. So this is also very important. Different type of bone tumors will affect different types of bone. So remember, osteoma, they are saying more commonly it is seen in the skull as well as the facial bones. Generally, the tumor is of no clinical significance except that it may protrude visible swelling. Sometimes it can be only in the form of the swelling. So the swelling can be seen, but other than the swelling, the patient will not have any other complaints like pain or another kind of discomfort. Nothing at all. You only visibly you will be able to see the swelling. So that is the presence of the tumor. Other than that, the patient will not experience any kind of difficulty or any kind of complaint because of that tumor. So that is in the case of osteoma. Sometimes it may bulge into one of the air sinuses, that are, you have the frontal sinus and ethmoidal sinus and others. So sometimes it can bulge into the air sinuses and cause obstruction to the sinus cavity, and it can lead to pain. So treatment for osteoma is, we know that it is not causing any discomfort and patient is not having any complaint, only visible swelling is present. So the treatment, there is no treatment is generally required except for cosmetic reasons, where a simple excision is sufficient and it is not a pre-malignant lesion. So we know, I told you already, what is the word meaning of the malignant? Malignant means it is spreading to the other areas. So when you say malignant lesion, that means the lesion originates in one part and then it transmits to the other part. So osteomas are non-malignant, so it cannot spread to the other parts, and usually you don't require any kind of treatment. What, as it is affecting the skull and the facial bones, so the facial appearance of the person or the patient will get affected. So for cosmetic reasons, if the patient want, then we can just do simple excision of the tumor. Simple excision means just the surgeon, orthopedic surgeon, will operate that part of the tumor and he will excise. Excise means to remove. So he will just excise and remove that part of the tumor. So that is called as the simple excision. Okay. So that is about osteoma. Now coming to the second type, that is the osteoid osteoma. So it is the commonest true benign tumor of the bone. Pathologically, it consists of a nidus of tangled arrays of partially mineralized osteoid trabeculae surrounded by dense sclerotic bones. So how the osteoid osteoma will look? If you see the histology part, then they are saying one nidus of tangled arrays of partially mineralized osteoid trabeculae will be there. So in between, in the center, you will have the trabecular system, which will be surrounded by a dense sclerotic bone. Sclerotic bone will be harder. So you can imagine that the center portion will have the trabecular system and the outer periphery of the tumor will have the sclerotic bone. So what will be the clinical presentation? The tumor is seen commonly between the ages of 5 to 25 years. So anybody who is aging from 5 to 25 years of age can have this tumor. The bones of the lower extremity are more commonly affected, tibia being the commonest. So this can be your MCQ question in your examination, that which bone is most commonly affected by osteoid osteoma. Then the answer will be the tibia bone. Okay. So remember, osteoid osteoma is more commonly affecting the lower extremity and tibia is being affected frequently. So the tumor is generally located in the diaphysis of the long bones. So also remember that this osteoid osteoma is affecting the diaphysis of the long bone. Posterior elements of the vertebra are a common site. The presenting complaint is a nagging pain, worst at night, and is relieved by salicylase. So in this kind of tumor, remember that the patient will have pain and which will be worst at night. So if the patient complains of night pain, then you have to suspect that the patient might have a tumor. There are minimal or no clinical signs except for a mild tenderness at the site of the lesion and a palpable swelling if it is a superficial lesion. So what are the clinical presentation? They are saying that the patient will have pain which will be worst at the night, and then no other changes will be there, but local, the point where the tumor is present in the bone at that particular region, tenderness can be there and palpable swelling also can be there. So how do we diagnose this osteoid osteoma? So diagnosis, it is generally confirmed on X-ray. So we have to take the X-ray, and then if the tumor is visible on the X-ray, then we can confirm the diagnosis that osteoid osteoma is present. The tumor is visible as a zone of sclerosis surrounding a radiolucent nidus, usually less than 1 centimeter in size. So they are saying that tumor, how the tumor will look on the X-ray? So zone of sclerosis surrounding a radiolucent nidus. So usually that will be less than 1 centimeter in size. So that will be visible on the X-ray. In some cases, the nidus may not be seen on a plain X-ray because of extensive surrounding sclerosis and may be detected on a CT scan. So figure 28.1A is showing this osteoid osteoma. So let me show you this. So you can see this picture A, okay, that is the lesion showing. You can see diaphysis. They are saying that tibia is most commonly affected and diaphysis is most commonly affected with osteoid osteoma. So the picture is visible on your screen, Vrunda. Right? Hello, Vrunda? Asha, you are able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So, let's go back. So, here we have talked about osteoid osteoma. So now let's see this WHO classification. WHO is World Health Organization, WHO classification for the nomenclature and classification of bone tumors. So the tumors are classified into different things. The first one is the bone forming tumors. Okay, so we can see it can be benign, it can be malignant, it can be intermediate. So benign tumors are the osteoid osteoma and osteoblastoma. Intermediate type of bone tumors are aggressive osteoblastoma. Malignant is osteosarcoma, conventional and variants. Now B type is having cartilage forming tumors. So in that also we have two types, benign and malignant. In case of benign, we have osteochondroma, enchondroma, chondromyxoid fibroma and chondroblastoma. In case of malignant cartilage forming tumors, we have chondrosarcoma. GCT, that is the giant cell tumor, in that we have benign GCT, intermediate GCT and malignant GCT. Then marrow tumors, we have the bone marrow, right, in the bone. So the tumors which are affecting the marrow of the bone, so that are malignant tumors, Ewing sarcoma, plasma cell tumor and multiple myeloma and lymphoma. Vascular tumors, it can be benign like hemangioma and gliomangioma. In case of malignant, there will be angiosarcoma. Other types of tumor, benign types, there can be neurilemoma and neurofibroma. In case of malignant tumors, there can be liposarcoma and there can be malignant fibrous histiocytoma. These are the different types. Tumor like lesion, so sometimes tumor like lesion can also be present in the bone. So these type of lesions are bone cysts. This cyst can be simple on aneurysmal cyst, fibrous dysplasia, reparative giant cell granuloma, fibrous cortical defect and eosinophilic granuloma. So these is the classification for the bone tumor. So if they are asking for 3 marks, write about the classification of the bone tumors, then you have to write this table. Okay, so now let's move on to the next type of tumor. So we have seen the osteoid, we have seen the osteoid osteoma. So your treatment for osteoid osteoma means you just have to do the complete excision of the nidus along with the sclerotic bone. Prognosis is usually good and it is not a pre-malignant condition. So another uncommon benign tumors of the bone, we have osteoblastoma, chondroblastoma, and hemangioma of the bone. So what is osteoblastoma? This is a benign tumor. Again, it's a benign tumor consisting of a vascular osteoid and new bone. It occurs in the jaw and the spine. If in the long bones, it occurs in the diaphysis or metaphysis, but never in the epiphysis. It occurs in patient in their second decade of life. So the patient presents with an aching pain radiographically. It is a well-defined radiolucent expansile bone lesion, 2 to 12 cm in size, and there is minimal reactive new bone formation, and treatment is by curettage. So the part which is the bone which is getting affected by the tumor, the surgeon will excise it and clean that particular area. So that is about your osteoblastoma. Remember, osteoblastoma is affecting the diaphysis and metaphysis of the bone, but it is never affecting the epiphysis. Second uncommon type of benign tumor is the chondroblastoma. This is a cartilaginous tumor containing the characteristic multiple calcium deposits. It occurs in the, so remember, calcium, multiple calcium deposits are seen in case of chondroblastoma. It occurs in young adults and is located around the epiphyseal plate. Bones around the knee are commonly affected with chondroblastoma. Radiologically, there is a well-defined lytic lesion surrounded by a zone of sclerosis. Areas of calcification within the tumor substance give rise to a mottled appearance, and treatment is by curettage and bone grafting. So what the surgeon will do here, he will excise the part of the chondroblastoma, and then bone grafting procedure can be performed. What is bone grafting procedure? So suppose the if the tumor was large enough, and then when once you excise the bone which was affected by the tumor, then you have to put the bone graft. So you surgeon can take a piece of the bone from some other normal bone, and then they will graft it in the place from where the tumor was excised. Next is hemangioma of the bone. So this is a benign tumor of angiomatous origin, commonly affecting the vertebrae and the skull. It occurs in the young adults. Common presenting symptoms are persistent pain and features of cord compression. At times, the lesion is asymptomatic. Typically, one of the lumbar vertebrae is affected. Radiologically, it appears as a loss of horizontal striations and prominence of vertical striation of the affected vertebral body. So this is affecting the vertebral body. The importance of this tumor lies in differentiating it from the commoner diseases like TB spine and metastatic bone disease of the spine. Treatment is by radiotherapy. So here, hemangioma of the bone, you can see this picture, this vertebra, you can see the red lines there, okay, in the vertebral body. So that is showing your hemangioma. Okay, so remember, hemangioma is more commonly seen in the case of spine, okay, vertebral bodies. Next is your edmontinoma. So it is a common tumor of the jawbone, also sometimes occurring in the tibia. In its lower half, it occurs between 10 to 35 years of age. The swelling is associated with only minimal pain, and it increases in size gradually. Typically, it appears as a honeycomb-like loculated lesion on the X-ray. The local recurrence is common, and treatment is by resection. Resection means removing that part of the tumor. Okay. So, edmontinoma, we can see in this picture 21.28.1D. So you can see here this picture. Okay, so this picture is showing us the how it will look in the case of edmontinoma. Okay, so they are saying resection. Resection means removal of the part of the bone which is affected by the tumor will be done. And the characteristic feature of the edmontinoma is the honeycomb-like appearance. Okay, and recurrence is common in this case. Okay, so recurrence means once the surgeon has removed the tumor, after some time again it will reappear in the bone. So that is called as the recurrence of the tumor. Okay, and the last is uncommon type of benign tumor. The last one we have is the chondroma. So what is chondroma? This is a locally malignant. So you can see this is malignant, but locally. Locally means where the part of the bone which is getting affected by this chondroma, near to that means locally near to that it can spread. So some, that is why it is called as locally malignant. Sometimes actually malignant tumor supposedly originating from the remnants of the notochord. Sacrum and cervical spine are the common sites. So remember, chondroma is commonly seen in case of your sacral bone, sacrum, and the cervical spine. It presents with a persistent pain and swelling, and sometimes with neurological deficit. So sometimes, since it is affecting the cervical spine, the nerve root may get affected, and that is why neurological deficit may be present. Bone destruction is the only hallmark feature of this tumor. So in this case of chondroma, we can see the destruction of the bone. And treatment wherever possible is complete excision. So we have to completely remove that part of the bone which is affected by the chondroma. And if complete excision is not possible, then radiotherapy is there. You know radiotherapy, what is radiotherapy? In radiotherapy, the rays will be entering into the patient body, and then they will try to destroy the tumor cells with the use of radiotherapy. So we have to do complete excision of the chondroma, and if it is not possible, then we have to go for radiotherapy. So picture 28.1E is showing the chondroma. So let us see. So this is the picture, chondroma. Picture E is showing the chondroma tumor, how it will look like. So we have already seen that it is affecting the sacrum as well as the cervical spine. So these are the picture again. So in your question paper, if they are asking you to write about the uncommon benign tumors, then you can mention this. You can also draw these diagrams, okay, and then label the diagram. So this is the first picture. Again, I will tell you, this is the osteoid osteoma. The second one is the chondroblastoma. C, picture C is hemangioma. Picture E is adenoma, and picture E is chordoma. Okay, so these are the benign tumors of the bone. So if they are asking for 3 marks benign tumors of the bone, you can write about these tumors, and then you can draw this picture as well as this classification of the bone tumor, which I have already explained to you. That also they can ask for 3 marks short note. Or if they are asking about benign tumors as in general for 15 mark long question, then in your long question you can add this classification. So that is all for today. Okay, so just wait here.